Cancer, Scorpio, you're over the hump message. How to get over the hump through the rest of the week, how to grow through the rest of the week, and how to be a better person. As always, the music that plays in the beginning of the reading is for you. Usually I don't remember or think about what the music is afterwards, but I know yours is geared towards some love songs, so we shall see. Maybe that's what you're reading about. I don't know. but how this goes is I will be reading a scripture off of the page that I'm writing on. It's a journal that I'm writing with all the readings. I have a scripture at the top. then we will be pulling one overall message from the 90s deck. The messages from the 90s tarot deck online, my virtual tarot reader. And then I'll be pulling four clarifying cards from the Modern Witch Tarot deck by Lisa Sterling. Alright, save. Let's go ahead and say our reading from the water signs that on your app and the messages, whatever you want me to pass on to you. Alright, first and foremost, please forgive me for any sins that I've committed. No matter how I said, anyone listening, I'm sorry, please just forgive them for their sins that they committed. Supposed to be perfect this year, so. But God, I thank you for the universe. Because in that, it relieves the pressure to be perfect, to always get it right. You are such a forgiving Father. I don't want things on purpose. I don't mean to step outside your will. When I do that, thank you for always being there, for always holding me on the ground, for always carrying me. God, I just ask that you extend that to everyone on your side of the side. That you hold them on the ground, God. Anyone that may have came up against me, that may be coming up against me, or may want to come up against me in the future, I just ask that you offer them the same love, grace, and respect you have always extended me, God. Thank you. God, you don't need no white places in my heart. You don't need no white here. I know I'm here to help my brothers and sisters, your children. But you truly know my purpose, God. And I just hope that every day that I'm walking closer and closer in that purpose. Thank you. And it's just actually whatever flows out of my life comes from you, God. You know, you know that if you're not in it, I don't want it. So if you're not in this, then separate me from this, God. If you are in this, then correct me where I'm wrong, steer me, direct me, protect me. I give you my life, God. I give you my life. And give your people me to help them be better individuals to help future generations. Thank you. Alright, so we're going to pull the overall message for water signs, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Hasta la vista, baby. So we have Six of Swords from the Terminator. On the card it says 2029 to 1984. So those dates might be significant. It's a long time period, but 2029 is in 6 years. Six may be significant. 1984 may be significant. So let's continue. something may need to end. You might be having to say goodbye to something. All right, so it says Terminator. No, 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 no. You gotta listen to me. You gotta listen to the way people talk. What is that with me changing the words? You don't say affirmative or some shit like that. You say no problemo. And if someone comes up to you with an attitude, you say eat me. And if you want to shine them on, it's hasta la vista, baby. Hasta la vista, baby, is a catchphrase associated with Arnold Schwarzenegger's titular character from the 1991 science fiction action film Terminator 2, Judgment Day. The term, I don't know why 2 just stuck out, but this is somebody saying something, I don't know. The term hasta la vista, literally, until the view, is a Spanish farewell that can generally be understood as meaning until the next time we see each other, or see you later, or goodbye. It's 1970. Bob Hope comically delivered the hasta la vista, baby, saying to Raquel Welch in the beginning of their Rocky Raccoon tribute on Raquel Welch's special Raquel. This term, with the added word baby, hasta la vista, baby, was later used in a popular hit song from 1987. Looking for a New Love by Grammy Award winner Jody Watley. It was also used in the 1968 tone lock single Wild Thing. So this is Six of Swords. Overall message, hasta la vista, baby, from the Terminator. Let's see. So we've got one card. Let's transition over for a second. Oh, this is not over. It is. Okay, so we got the first card. Four Swords in reverse, the Magician, and Nine of Cups. Okay. So, with the Six of Swords, and once again, we also will clarify everything with the actual definitions and what the cards mean, but this is what I'm getting from it. So, hasta la vista, baby, Terminator, change is going on, something, you're saying goodbye to something, something is happening, you're releasing something. And then we have Seven of Cups. In reverse. So I'm getting all of your gifts, your passions, your treasures, your abundance, you may be losing that. It's upside down. So what that's giving me is pouring out. You may have poured out all your gifts and stuff, maybe the wrong things, people, or you may be going through, it's not here, but a tower moment. You're losing things. Things are falling out. Then we have Four Swords. So it looks like you're So what originally I was gonna say levitating above the swords. And what it's giving is, okay, your eyes are closed. You're right now you're above maybe some drama, some trauma, some issues, some obstacles, some pain, what feels like death. Like you're staring that in the face, but you're closing your eyes, so you're technically you're not staring it in the face. You're not facing it. It feels like if you open your eyes, you're gonna fall on it. You're gonna die. You're holding your stomach. You're queasy. Like as long as you keep your eyes closed, you're okay. You can live. Everything's upside down right now. The magician. I'm getting that you still have the power to change it for the better. Like, you are the magician. You have the power. Or you might be playing with some magicians or some magic. You're trying to, you took the sword, you took the cup, and you're taking the magic and you're trying to make something new come from it. You're taking what you were dealt. You're taking your empty cups, your losses, you're taking the pain, and you're transforming it. And then you have your nine of cups behind you. And so the interesting thing is, it doesn't look full, like there's nothing in the cup, but you have two additional cups and you're proud of those cups. So you're content with whatever level you're at. You don't necessarily have to be overflowing, have to have everything. You're learning that to be content with what you have, and that brings in more. Maybe you're changing some mindsets about money or career or how you view success, what success means to you. Okay, so let's clarify. Really quick. So we said we have Hasta La Vista, baby. Six of Swords from Terminator. So, like I said, that was felt like a transition. You were saying bye to something. So it does mean transition, change, rite of passage, releasing baggage. then we have Seven of Cups. So Seven of Cups is love, spiritual wisdom, money, success, power. It seems like all the treasures are just out there waiting for you to grab. You're dreaming so big, they're dreaming clouds and totally out of touch with reality. It's time to step back down to earth and do the hard work required to be mentally healthy. Only then can those big dreams become attainable. Four Swords was your next card. And that is saying the struggle is real and you're goddamn exhausted. I take that back because I feel like at least God forgive me. You're daggone exhausted. You've been putting time and energy fully into all the outer aspects of your life, like friends, your relationships, or your job, and you have forgotten to care of yourself. You are worn out. So take a break, relax, close your eyes, meditate, take a nap, do what you need in order to recharge. Then we have the magician. So with the magician, it's time to make some magic. To turn dreams into reality, a magician knows what she wants and knows what she'll need to make it happen. Standing confidently and boldly, brandishing a wand towards the sky, the magician channels magic and inspiration into herself and transforms it into creative energy. Laid out before her is all she needs on a crystalline pedestal, the sword, her smarts, and wig prepares her for the task ahead. Her cup is full and emotionally connects the magician to her goal. The pinnacle is the life experience that taught her how the world works. The other wand drives her forward into action. Bring those lofty dreams down to earth, make them real. You know what you want, and you have the magic within you to make it happen. Believe in yourself. You know what you're ready to start creating. Let that inspiration flow through you and use all your tools to make some stuff. And then we have Nine of Cups. And Nine of Cups is saying, treat yourself. You've been killing it lately. You deserve a nice reward after your success and accomplishments. Throw a party. Buy yourself something nice. Have a spa day. Do something you want to only for you. Slow yourself. Show yourself the love you deserve. So slow yourself down, possibly. And show yourself the love you deserve. Alright, that concludes the Over the Hump message for the water signs, Pisces, Cancer, and Scorpio.